This is my thinking. Whatever has brought us to this state of affairs today can be considered a failure. So what I am thinking in my head is that as I'm going into this day of battle or whatever, I must do it differently to achieve a different set of results. Whatever it is they have done like this, I don't even need to think before I do it like this, so that there will be a different result. If doing it this way has brought us failure so far, the disenfranchisement of the youth of this country, where we have totally destroyed the middle class. I told you about my background, and particularly my aggressive background, which was supposed to fill our children, to give them space to fill up. That is middle level manpower. We needed to develop a middle level manpower. We needed to put children into productive uses. It is not everybody that will operate at the scientific research level to go to a university. There are those that will need a polytechnic, a college of technology, a university of education, as well as who are the drivers of the industry. And technology that we're doing today, the new technology, that is it, that's the production area. You're talking technology, you're talking culture, you're talking the arts, you're talking sports. Those are huge areas for our youth to go into, because it's really for youth. So when we create this world, you know, what I get to do is a project-driven new world. Create the projects, and the young people will just gravitate in their thousands towards them. That is the environment we are going to create. I'm not going to come here and tell you I'm going to create social jobs, I'm going to create this, I'm going to create that. No. It's to create the environment for those things to thrive. And generally, again, I'm a football man. I don't have the answers. I am a team player. In a team, you get the striker, you get the Adoki on the left, you get the Moda Awali. They all play different things. In the end, you all play as a team, as one unit, all play different. I'm just, in this case, I'm a team leader, I'm the captain of the team. I can't play all those. I don't even know how the left back plays, because my role is as I like. So we are going to assemble the best possible team in the United States, made up of those young people that we are going to talk about. This is going to be an inclusive government. Zenith Labour Party does not have anybody. It is an empty shell. And we are going around and we are shopping for people to fill into the coming government in all spheres of life. And we are telling them, bring the best amongst you to come and be part of this government. Bring the best amongst you from the different sectorial groups. And we are going to have a government for the first time, not just in Nigeria, anywhere, that will comprise a leadership that is not connected by the whole party to the followership within our government. That's what we have for the first time. A true democracy where people will pick people based on merit. It's meritocracy. Based on merit. Not because an APC and everybody just vote for APC. And no matter who they present, they become part of the government. No. This time, watch out for what's going to happen in the state. What God is doing in the state. They are going to have a government that has a governor who is conservative the government. House of Assembly will have two from Green Party, one from APC, three from PDP, one from... It's going to be an art mixture of everybody coming in with their different strengths to come and form the government. The issue of youth is very paramount on my mind. Because they made me what I am. I told you when I was a student, I was a young person, the opportunities I got, those opportunities will come. Because the best amongst the youth are going to be part of this government to formulate for us those things that will interest the youth. But generally, I've told you about the climate. We are going to go to technology, passion of the youth, the arts, passion of the youth, sports, passion of the youth, and set up projects that will drive the multiplication of their application. Thank you. In our own world, though, there's no you can win or you cannot win. You don't go into a battle thinking that there's a possibility that we don't win. No. You are going as a sports person, I'm going there to go and win. What happens is that's their business. For me, I am going there to win. Okay? So I care. So that's on a lighter note. Take this, put it in your pocket. Go home and think about it and enjoy it. So that you can now start to, when it starts to happen, you can now say, yes, Segun told us about it. He described it. One morning, National Stadium, Surulere, we played the finals of the FA Cup. Finals of the FA Cup was played in the morning. I don't know, against Raka Rovers. And I lost the penalty kick. I scored the free kick. And then we knocked them out. And as soon as the match ended, spectators just came from the terrace, the rest of the field. And somebody took my right shoe, somebody took the left, somebody took my left socks, right socks, they forced my jersey, you know, from my body. Somebody took my shorts. Fortunately, I was wearing that G-string thing. And they carried me from the middle of the National Stadium. They carried me sky high in my nakedness. And they were seeking supporters. They carried me out of the stadium to a waiting car. Bola Bakri, my friend, former bank manager, his car was waiting to take me back to the hotel. They went to the car, opened it, and advised him not to start the car. So they put me inside that car, and they started to push that car from the National Stadium all the way to San Shonibare in Surulere. All traffic in Lagos on that day grounded to a halt because they were pushing that car. There I was naked inside the car, sweating, and people were coming out of their homes and wondering what was going on. And it was mathematical, and women were praying. The whole streets were damned in Surulere. Affected the whole of traffic all over Lagos on that day as they were pushing me from Surulere, from the National Stadium to San Shonibare. That is the power of a football star. Have they ever tasted the power of a retired football star? They have never tasted it. They have never tasted it. The power of a retired football star. I will tell you what it is. Kanye West has told me it is coming. Olumide has told me it is coming. Peter Rufai has told me it is coming. Victor Ipeba has told me it is coming. Not because they love Zenith fans, they don't even know it. But because there is a retired football player, one of their own, who is daring the impossible. And on that day, when they land in Abeokuta, it will reverberate in the Jebundi. They will hear the sound in Ilaro. Some water will be jammed with traffic. They will be wondering what is going on. Because the football star, the retired football star, would have unleashed the most powerful force in the universe on that day. A retired footballer will be governor of the state. I thank you very much.